Hi, let's talk about the vasculature of the orbit. The orbit's blood supply is the ophthalmic artery, and it's drained by the ophthalmic veins. The ophthalmic artery is a branch of the internal carotid artery, which we can see here on its way into the cranial cavity. The internal carotid artery traverses the cavernous sinus, and its first branch is the ophthalmic artery. And we cannot see it here, it is obscured, but the ophthalmic artery does travel along with cranial nerve 2, which is the optic nerve, through the optic canal. We can kind of see the ophthalmic artery there as it crosses over cranial nerve 2, and it is moving along the medial wall of the orbit between the superior oblique muscle and the medial rectus muscle. The ophthalmic veins, of which there are two, drain the orbit of blood. And here we can see the superior ophthalmic vein, which drains the superior aspects of the orbit and the eye with blood. Can anastomose with branches of the facial veins around there, and can be a route for infections to travel back to the cavernous sinus. That superior ophthalmic vein travels through the superior orbital fissure on its way back to the cavernous sinus. The cavernous sinus is going to be located deep here, just lateral to the cella turcica, and we'll see that in a subsequent slide. So the ophthalmic artery, as we can see here, let me outline it for us again. We can see it just crossing over there again, has a branch inside the optic nerve called the central artery of the retina. We can see that there. We can also see the ophthalmic artery traveling through the optic canal with cranial nerve 2. Let's get a better look at that central retinal artery. Here we're looking at the posterior aspect of the eye. It's been clean. And this is a transected optic nerve. And within that optic nerve, bundled in the dural sheath, is the central retinal artery. That central retinal artery, its branches, can actually be seen with the help of a fundoscope on the surface of the retina. And then finally, we have the cavernous sinus. Well, let's first orient ourselves. So there is the internal carotid artery. I can see a little bit of the internal carotid artery there as well. That's the part of it that is traversing the cavernous sinus. Let me just outline that cavernous sinus for us here. So this space is part of the cavernous sinus. This space here, part of the cavernous sinus. That space there is cavernous sinus. And that space there is cavernous sinus. And we can see that there are quite a few nerves associated with the cavernous sinus. So within the cavernous sinus, we have the internal carotid artery. We've mentioned that already. There's also going to be the abducens nerve. So that's cranial nerve 6. And within the wall of the cavernous sinus, we have cranial nerves 3, 4, and V1. So let's take a look at that. So here is 3. The oculomotor nerve. Here is 4, the trochlear nerve. And then V1 is there. V2 there. And that's V3. So V3, V2, and V1. That cavernous sinus is going to communicate with many other dural sinuses within the cranial cavity. In particular, it drains to the petrosal sinuses. So we've discussed the ophthalmic artery and its supply to the orbit, as well as the superior ophthalmic vein, the cavernous sinus, and the associations of other neurovasculature with the cavernous sinus. Thank you for your time.